Hi, everybody. My name is John DePietro, and on behalf of my colleague, Bob Zagami, who is out on assignment today, we want to welcome you to the Camper Report Show. You know, it's no secret that more and more RVers than ever before are now living full-time in their RV and working full-time in their RV. If you want to be one of those people, you will enjoy the interview that I did with the founder of the Remote Work School. So that interview, plus all the news of the week of the RV industry, is coming up right now on the Camper Report Show. Hey, everybody, my name is John DePietro. Welcome back to the news segment of the Camper Report Show. You know, every week we bring you the financial news of the industry, and this week is no different. So many large companies within the industry are enjoying record numbers. Now, Lippert Components, LCI, they make aftermarket parts, and they make parts like doors and steps and parts that fit within your brand new RV. They reported record sales for the first quarter that just ended of over $1 billion. That's right, folks, $1 billion. That is a 52% increase from the same time period last year. Also, another giant company that is setting records is Camping World. And they did over $1.5 billion in retail sales during the first quarter, an increase of $500 million over the same time period last year. And the largest family-owned group of RV dealerships in the United States, which is Campers Inn, which has stores on the East Coast and the eastern part of the United States, basically going all the way from New Hampshire down into Florida, has opened a new facility in Elkhart, Indiana. It's a PDI facility, which allows Campers in units that are made at the factories in Elkhart to be inspected right there before they're shipped off to their 20 plus stores throughout the United States. So what they want to do is avoid having to send the unit back if anything is wrong with it before the customer gets a hold of it. So with that being said, that is a synopsis of the highlights of the news of the week in the RV industry. We're going to be right back with a great story right after this. Stay with us, everybody.
I'm Jesse from Outsiders Calling, and I love adventurous family travel with my wife, Jenny, and our son, Tucker.
For over 3 years, we've RV'd across the U.S. and Mexico, and it's tough to find places that meet all our needs.
Now, we plan our trips with the RV Trip Wizard, pull it up in the RV Life app, select it, and go.
It helps us discover amazing new places to grow together as a family.
RV Trip Wizard with the RV Life app is an awesome trip planning combination.
You can get both for one low annual price. Check out rvlife.com to learn more.
Hey, everybody, it's John DePietro, and welcome back to this section of the Camper Report Show. You know, the interesting part about the RV life in the past year or so, since this thing called COVID came in, is that more and more people, because of the flexibility that they have with their schedule, are hitting the road in an RV. And studies show that 70 or 80% of those new people hitting the road are first-time RV owners. And which leads me directly to our guest for this segment. Her name is Camille Attell. Did I say it right, Camille?
You did.
I did. And she is basically a nomad. And a few years ago, her and her husband, as they say, traded corporate America for North America. But not only do they talk the talk and walk the walk, but they help others how to do the same. And Camille, welcome to A Story About You.
Oh, thanks for having me. That might have been the best intro anyone has ever said. Very, very well said.
Well, you know, we want to thank you for taking time from your busy day, because what you really are now is a teacher. Because there is so much that you need to learn about before you even shop for an RV or decide that the RV lifestyle is for you. And you have those resources available online. and through consultations. Tell us a little bit about, first of all, your background, where you're from, where you live now, what you did prior to hitting the road, and then bring us right up to date in 30 seconds or less.
Oh boy, no pressure there. Sure. No so my husband Bryce and I worked, like you say, in corporate America, more than 20 years, 20, 30, gosh, maybe even longer than that when you combine our ages. And in 2016, we pretty much had enough. We just had a series of events that led us to look at the future ahead and say, holy cow, is this what we're going to do for the rest of our lives? We were not near retirement. We're in a pre-retirement age, which is roughly between 45 to 65, and not able to retire or even ready to retire, but also didn't want to work at the same type of job for the next 20 years. And so I think a lot of people can relate to feeling that way. So we looked around and we thought, what can we do? And we settled on this whole RV lifestyle thing that you're talking about. But we had never RV'd. So when you talk about, you know, first time RVers, we were in that category. I mean, we literally had never been in an RV, much less drove around in one. And so we left everything behind back then, nearly five years ago now. We just threw the shackles off and said, you know, forget it. We're just going to try this out. And that's what we did. We traveled full time for almost 4 years. We hit, 40 something states, over 37,000 miles. And the whole time we taught ourselves how to work remotely and earn money as nomads, as you say. So that is my slightly over 30 second summary.
Yeah. Well, you know, the big question that people have is, how can I do this? Well, there's really kind of two issues right now. Number one is you cut the corporate ties, which is what you guys did, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you develop an income that way, regardless of how you do it. The second way to do it, which a lot of people are doing now, is they're still staying employed with the big company, but they don't have to schlep it into the office every day across that Golden Gate Bridge or that George Washington Bridge. You know, spend 2 hours driving in, 2 hours coming home, getting home at 9 o'clock at night and rinse and repeating and doing the same thing over again. Their star is probably a little bit different because they have to, still do the same work, but just do it in a different way. Is that another thing that you're seeing in the past year with people like that in that situation, not necessarily totally freelancing, but
yes.
But traveling and working?
Yeah, and everything in between. And I should mention, you asked what my background is, and I forgot to mention that I come from corporate training, very traditional corporate training, employee development environments my entire career.
How to be an employee.
Yeah, how to be a good employee, right? I mean, that's the irony of all of this, right? But you're right. I mean, there are a lucky few who are able to take their location-based job on the road. I will say COVID certainly helped, if I could use the word help when you describe a pandemic, but it facilitated the trend that was already happening, which is a lot of companies allowing people to go remote. All that did is accelerate it for those who are able to keep their job and negotiate that. And so what I've seen over the past number of years, and by the way, today what I do is I own and operate Remote Work School, which is where I teach and train people how to either find remote work, start remote businesses. And what I see are what I call hybrid remote work models. So everything from what you're describing, people who can keep their job and still work the same job from an RV, all the way to, you know, people who are dabbling in freelancing, trying their hand at entrepreneurship, all the way into going full into entrepreneurship and saying, you know what, this is my chance. Let me try starting a business from my RV. So I have seen literally every possible remote work model that exists, I'm pretty sure.
So without giving away your secrets to remote work school, what would be the first semester, if you will? What do people have to look into right away when they enter your school?
Sure, I'm happy to give away all my secrets. I'm a big believer in just giving away as much value as possible. In my course doesn't run in semesters, but really it's more of a journey that a lot of people will take. And so what a lot of people do, one of the first mistakes, let me start with that people make when they step into this lifestyle, and when I say lifestyle, I mean RVing as well as working remotely, is most people look around and say, huh, what are the jobs that are out there and how do I apply to them?
Yeah.
And that is really, that's a big giant mistake in my opinion and in my expertise, because what you do when you do that is it's a very disempowering way to approach something by looking around and saying, what's out there? I like to tell people that one of the first steps you should do is you should really dig deeper into your identity. A lot of people get hung up on their old work identity. Oh, I used to be a this, I used to be an office manager, I used to be a project manager, whatever. And you have to shed that old identity and really dig deeper into your skills, your talents, your strengths, and your stories, because those things we need to mine to really reinvent a new identity that puts us in a more empowering position to get the type of remote work that we want and deserve.
Right. So, and would you agree that everybody's story has value? And even yes. though because it's yours, you might not think it's the greatest thing in the world, but you might be an inspiration to someone else who's in the same boat. And, sharing really gives you more good stuff in the heart than yes. just selling, right?
100%. And I think you said something that is so powerful. All of our stories have value, and we forget they have value because they're ours. And that is like the second mistake, I guess. There's not that many mistakes, but that one comes up a lot, where I see people discounting their skills and their strengths simply because it's easy for them, right? Like, we all have things we can do that feel easy because they're natural for us. And when they're easy and natural, we don't think they're a skill. And therefore we discount them as having value. And when we discount our skills, we discount our income. And that is a big mistake that I see people make, especially pre-retirement age people in my age bracket that are pivoting perhaps into a new career. And they feel like they need to charge less money or ask for less salary because they're starting something new. And I say, heck no, if anything, try to charge more money because you're coming to the table with a lot more experience. But there is a process to do that.
And pivot is the big word now, along with I'll circle back, but that's another topic. But pivot is a big word because there are people that are no longer under the guidelines of you go to college and you get a job and you stay there regardless of how miserable you are. You stay there for 40 to 45 years and then you get a watch and a party. Then you say, coulda, shoulda, woulda.
Yeah.
But now people are saying, I'm going to. They can say it at any time because the old way of doing things, of staying in that career you can still stay in the same career.
Sure.
But you don't have to stay with the same company and be handcuffed and be stifled. And don't you find that when you talk to people on the road, that let me rephrase that. Mm-hmm. Have you ever bumped into anybody on the road who said, I wish I stayed in corporate America?
You know what? That's a really great question. No. I mean, even people who really liked their jobs or really liked the security, and I was one of those people, by the way. My husband and I had great jobs. We were very fortunate in that way. I did not want to leave my job, to be honest. I wanted to take it with me on the road. At that time, my company said, no, we don't do that here. Of course, last year, they were able to make that happen for thousands of people in a week because of COVID. So I do not regret leaving that job. It was comfortable. It was safe. It was relatively secure. And I don't even believe in security.
Relatively, anymore. Right.
Yeah. But the stuff I'm doing now is so much more exciting. I'm more engaged in life. I am really understanding my real talent and the things I should have been doing long ago, but I didn't have to because I, worked at my cubicle every day and, I wasn't really forced to learn about myself. So no, there's not even one person I can think of who said, gee, I made a giant mistake. Cause you can always go back. I mean, really.
That's the thing.
You can always go back. Yeah.
You can't always, we're in an issue right now that another learning part of COVID is that your health is so valuable. And so many people say, I'm going to wait until I'm 65. And statistics show that that's when you spend all your time planning your activity around your doctor's appointments.
Oh, wow. That's really, I've been studying a lot of that because I'm getting deeper and deeper into that pre-retirement, retirement population. And wow, I hadn't even thought about that perspective. I think that's really something to think about. Yeah.
Well, how can you help our viewers? What are the services that you offer? Tell us about a website. I know you got that website, More Than a Wheelin'.
Yes.
We'll put that down here anyway, but what other services that you do you offer to people that are wanting to cut the cord, but just haven't decided or felt that they were capable?
Yeah, that's great. Well, so More Than a Wheelin' is a fantastic place to start. That's the RV website that my husband Bryce and I started back in 2016. And then now I also, as I mentioned, own and operate Remote Work School. And I actually have a new website coming out very, very soon. I don't know if it'll be out by the time, you know, this is available, but it's just CamilleAttell.com. And on CamilleAttell.com, I will have so many more resources, free resources, actually, free trainings, you know, things that can get people started. And then if people want to continue working with me, I also have a paid program, Remote Work School. And like I mentioned, that is a whole system that really teaches people about the remote work income system. That is my methodology to help people understand how to get started, how to delve into their talents, find the right remote work, whether it's with a job or in a freelance career, and how to just move through that process more smoothly, as well as how to charge what you're worth. Because that to me is, again, one of the things that breaks my heart. Yeah, when I see people undercharging. So that's the new project I'm working on. I'm really just getting all of that together to re-release it in its newest form.
Right. So Camille, we want to thank you so much for taking time from your busy day, hectic day to be with us here on the Camper Report Show. And all of your contact information will be here on the screen or down below in the show notes. My name is John DePietro. Her name is Camille Attell. I was going to call you something. Camille Attell. That's a heck of a closing. I should start my closing all over again. But you know what? We do this live to tape, just like they used to do the Tonight Show. So if there's anything in it that doesn't look perfect, and you know what? You don't have to be perfect, do you?
That's right. Nope. Just, perfect is boring.
Just be you.
That's right.
Okay.
Awesome. Camille, thanks for having me.
Thank you so much. Have a great day, everybody.